Will you, Bill, take Dawn to be your wife? And will you now promise, in the presence of God and before these gathered witnesses, to be a loving, faithful, and loyal husband to her, whatever may come, until God shall separate you by death? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Will you, Dawn, take Bill to be your husband? And will you now promise, in the presence of God and before these gathered witnesses, to be a loving, faithful, and loyal wife to him, whatever may come, until God shall separate you by death? If so, answer, I will. The Fowler family and the Unterseer family, do you give your blessing to Dawn and Bill and promise to do everything in your power to uphold them in marriage? If so, please respond with the sentence that I will read. We rejoice in your union.
We rejoice in your union.
And pray God's blessing upon your home.
And pray God's blessing upon your home.
And to the friends of Bill and Dawn and the congregation, you have come to witness this exchange of vows. Will you do all in your power to support this marriage now and in the years to come? If so, answer, we will.
We will.
Let us pray. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understanding all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver up my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will all pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it too will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall fully know, even as I have been fully known. So now, faith, hope, and love abide. These three, but the greatest of these is love. Amen. In your marriage, as a witness to your families, your church, the people you work with, and indeed to the world. So I would encourage you today, never, ever leave God out of this marriage. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit play a vital part in this marriage that you two now enter into. So God has blessed us today. God has blessed you. And with that love, you can go forth knowing that by that, you are showing Jesus to the world. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And look at your dear. I, Bill, receive you, Dawn, as a gift from God,
as a gift from God,
to be my lifelong companion,
to be my lifelong companion.
I will love you through laughter and tears.
I will love you through laughter and tears.
Through health and sickness.
Through health and sickness.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty.
At work and at play.
Work and at play.
I will love you constantly.
I will love you constantly.
And with the deepest loyalty.
With the deepest loyalty.
I will prayerfully seek. Your joy and happiness throughout our lives. Amen. Dawn, would you repeat after me, please? I, Dawn,
receive you, Bill,
as a gift from God.
As a gift from God.
To be my lifelong companion.
I will love you through laughter and tears.
Through health and sickness.
In plenty and in want.
At work and at play.
I will love you constantly.
And with the deepest loyalty.
I will prayerfully seek.
Your joy and happiness. Throughout our lives. Amen. What shall be the sign of this union? Dawn, I give you this ring as a sign of my vow, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Bill,
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Bill and Dawn have chosen to light a unity candle that you see the two tapers there on the table that represent their individual lives. The unity candle is really more of a recent family. The center candle is lighted by the bride and groom after the exchange of vows and the exchange of rings. The side candles remain lighted to symbolize that each partner retains his or her physical and personal identity while the two are united as husband and wife. And as they go forward to light that unity candle representing their oneness, they've asked us to listen to the words that you have in your program, Journey as One.
Step by step on my road.
perfect song.
Beautiful.
It really speaks about this journey that you guys have begun. Well, you began it quite a few years ago. But you know, life gets in the way sometimes. But God, in his great love for the two of you, has brought you to this point today. So that unity candle that you just lit symbolizes that Bill and Dawn are joined together as one flesh. They have become one and are intended to treat each other as if they were part of their own flesh. Just as Genesis 2, 23 and 24 says, "Then the man said, this is at last bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of man this one was taken. Therefore, a man leaves his father and his mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh." Bill and Dawn, you have declared your vows and you have given symbols of your love before God and this congregation. May God confirm and fill you with his grace. And now to you people of this congregation, Dawn and Bill have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings. Bless you and preserve you. Christ the Lord honor your vows with his peace.
Yes.
God the Holy Spirit fill you with his love as you seek his will and do it. And to the congregation, bear witness to the love of God in this world, so that those to whom love is a stranger will find it in your generous friends. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You may kiss your bride.
All right. Woo-hoo! Yay!
Well. Wasn't planning on that one. It is now my privilege to present to you, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Bill Fowler, Jr.
Yay!
Yeah.